Hello student, welcome to Vastech channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today we will see how to execute basic experiments by using digital trainer kit. This is the digital trainer kit 4004 we use in the lab to execute various experiments in digital electronics. So let me explain first different sections of this digital trainer kit. So now these are called as IC holders. So we have total here 6 IC holders, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Depending on the requirements of a number of ICs in your circuit design, you can use this one. Either you can use 2 IC holder or you can use all the IC holders. So next one is, this is called as input-output section. This is the input-output section. Here you will give input. For example, suppose this is the input-output switch. If I on this switch, then you are going to give logical 1. If I off it, then it is logical 0. 1, 0. 1, 0. Then this is called as output section, where you will see the output. Other than that, we have breadboard to connect various components, like various active and passive components you can connect here along with these circuits. And other than that, we have DC power supply section. You can give plus 5 volt to the IC, minus 12 volt, plus 12 volt. Then we have something called as clock section. From here you can give various different clocks, clock frequency to the IC, to the circuit diagram, depending on the need. So you can see here 1 Hz, 10 Hz, 100 Hz, 1 kHz, etc. So the last section is something called a 7 segment display. This is used to display 0 to 9, 8 to F. Some experiment you need to display 0 to 9, 8 to F. For that one, we are using this one. So now, first, here I have kept some ICs. In that couple of ICs, I will take you to explain how it works. So first, let me take IC 7404. Normally, you will identify IC by its number. You can see there CD. Let me zoom it. CD 7404. That means, in between some numbers are there, you leave it 7404. That means this is a NOT gate IC. So I have explained in my previous video what is a NOT gate, and 7404 IC contains 6 gates inside that. I have explained in my previous video. Now, how to identify pin number? So normally you have to hold the IC like this. You have to hold the IC like this. When you hold the IC like this, on the left hand side, that is the pin number, there is a notch you can see at the top. There is a notch you can see. And on the left hand side of that notch, pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And on the other side, down 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So like this, we have a 16 pin IC also. Here you can see one more IC. Let me take one more IC. Yeah, this IC. So now this IC is a 16 pin IC. This IC is 16 pin IC. So pin number 1 to 8 on the one side, and on the other side 9 to 16. So now let me connect this NOR gate. So properly you have to, NOT gate. Properly you have to insert this IC in the IC holder. So first hold the IC like this and identify the pin number 1. Here you can see this latch or lever. Pull up the lever, place the IC in the IC holder properly, not like this. If you place the IC like this, this is a 14 pin IC. If you place like this, then the pins are not aligned. You can see at the top here, one slot is left out here. You see just slop here, one slot is left out. So what you do, you have to place it properly. At the bottom now, one row slot is left out. That is okay. That is okay because it's 14 pin IC. So now, and after that, push this lever like this. Now this IC will not come out. This IC is locked now. It will not come out. Now, how to do the connectivity? Here, this is the pin number 1, pin number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Since it is a 14 pin IC, after 7, this is not 8, this is 8. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. And 14 is called as VCC, and our 7 is called as ground for this IC. 14 is called as VCC and 7 is called as a ground for this IC. So now we have to do the connectivity. To do the connectivity, this is called as a patch cord. This is called as patch cord. This is the called as patch cord. Normally, this patch cord is nothing but a wire cable. This is used to connect various pins of the IC. Now, what I will do is, first I have to check whether the patch cord is correct or not. Whether the patch cord is correct or not. How to check the continuity of the patch cord? One way to check the continuity of the patch cord is by using multimeter. You can check the continuity, whether the cable is working or not. Otherwise, you can connect it from input to the output. From the input to the output, you can connect it and you can give input one here. At the same time, you can see output one. That means this cable is correct. Okay. Now, we will check the various gates of this NOT gate, various gates of this 7404 IC. For that, let me switch on the main power supply, then switch on the power button on the trainer kit. So now it is on. Now what I will do is, I have connected the IC, I told you how to connect the IC. Now I will give power supply to the IC, that is VCC. Which pin is VCC? Pin number 16 is VCC. Sorry, 14 is VCC. This is 14, not 16, because it is a 14 pin IC. So I will connect it here, VCC. And I have to do the one more connection, that is ground. Pin number 7 is ground. That I will give it to ground. Now you have done VCC and ground connection. Once that is over, after that, what we will do is, we will give the input. So, pin number 1 is the input. You have to refer the data sheet for this one. Pin number 1 is the input. So, input is connected. Pin number 1 is the input. Input is connected. Then, pin number 2 is the output. 2 is the output. So, pin number 2 is the output. So, where I will connect? I will connect it to the output section. Now, don't get confused here. I have connected and I have given here 0. See, it is 0 and you will get the output 1. Because, you know, for the NOT gate, if you give 0, output is 1. If I give 1, output is 0. 0, 1, 1, 0. So, you can connect it anywhere, but you have to follow the particular protocol. See, now it is only one cable is there, but there are in later experiments, you can see, you have to connect 100 patch cords, that time you will get confused. So, follow the proper protocol what we tell in the lab. So, let me take one more IC, 7408, this is 7408 AND gate. I will connect this one, once again, this IC. So, you can see here. You can see here, I have connected this IC properly with the aligned with pin number 1 properly. So, now after inserting this IC into the IC slot, you have to connect VCC, pin number 14 is VCC, pin number 7 is a pin number 7 is a ground. Pin number 7 is a ground. Pin number 7 is ground. Then we will take one gate in that IC. So pin number 1 and 2 are the input, 3 is the output of one AND gate in 7408. So pin number 1, I will connect it to this input. Pin number 2 also I will connect to input. Pin number 2 also I will connect to input. And pin number 3 is output. I will connect it to output. I have done the connection now. You can see simple connections. So why you can ask why this is the one gate. So this 08 contains 4 gates. So, in that one gate, I am checking now. So, pin number 1 and 2 are the input, 3 is the output. So, you can see 3 is the output. 1 and 2 are the input. Now here you have to give input and you have to see the output. See, you know AND gate. Suppose if I give 0, 0, what is the output here? Output is 0. Then I will make 0, 1. Output is a 0. Then 0, 1. 1, 0. Output is 0. 1, 1. Output is 1. So let me repeat. 0, 0. Output is 0. 0, 1. 0, 1. Output is 0. 1, 0. AND gate. Output is 0. 1, 1. Output is a 1. In this way, you can execute various experiments.